You know, I'll show you right here. You know, like we talked about earlier, we've got, you know, this is my hub. And right here, I've got clients, and I can do dot others, dot groups, et cetera, dot users, et cetera. And essentially what I would do at that point, and I'll just kind of grab this and copy it out here. And what I can actually do is give it, I think that's a dynamic. So what I can do is literally just give it any method, do work, foo. Boop. Or I could say 24 and it would actually send that out. Actually, I'm gonna do something over there. That's what it used to look like. Send async. So in this case, this is when I'm sending a message from the server to the clients. My IntelliSense is getting all messed up. So in this case, I would just give it a name, and that's my method name. And if you think about it, that's almost like, it's not really a method name as much as it is an event name on the client. Makes sense. So you can see here, control locked, control unlocked. Those are almost like events that I'm going to fire. And then I could just, you know, send it 42, the answer to all questions. Or I would have to new up an object array. I could do it like that. Being lazy. Just send 42, and I could send, you know, Tom. So I can send, you know, any series of objects that I want at that point. Getting weird errors. Sorry for my IntelliSense. Now, this is how you would send a message to the server. Excuse me, to the clients from the server. So, you know, obviously the next step is going to be, how do you actually handle those events that happen to be coming from the server? So what I would do, and you look at my awful JavaScript code, my awful old JavaScript code here. If I were to open up real time, what you would see in here is that the first stage that you do is you want to actually create the connection, but we'll get into that in a minute. I'll talk to you about connections in a minute. So think about this side, which is send core async, which is basically just sending, you know, sending an event to the client. And then how do you handle it right here? Connection dot on. And the first parameter of that is the name of the event that you want to handle. So control locked, control unlocked, you know, clicked, whatever, you know, server full, you know, pick your poison. You know, any event that is going to be fired or sent from here, I can literally just use that same string as the string. Sorry for string magic. You can actually do it over here. And then this is, you know, an expression where I can basically just say, I know what I'm getting back from the server. And I can just basically come up with my event handler and deal with that event argument coming in right here. So like you talked about, like, it was fun to show this in class, because like people think about all the complexity of like RPC and the complexity of server push, and for the love, the complexity of writing your own protocol in something like WebSocket. What we have here is exactly what you would think you would have to have in, going to use this term loosely, a pub sub kind of an experience or an event driven experience. I want to send an event to the clients and I want to handle the event on those clients. Using whatever logic I have.
It's exactly how it should work.
Simple. Yeah, it's insanely simple. I'll show you the one gotcha. From a coding perspective, if you're using the ASP.NET Core side, okay, if you're doing the Azure SignalR service, you don't have the server. You don't have the server. So you've got the service and you can basically fire events out to your, you know, your clients all you want to. If you're in ASP.NET Core server-side land, what you've got is essentially when you wire it up, you essentially have to do this, which basically dials in all the SignalR stuff on the server. And then if you want to map the route to that hub, this is essentially what you would do on the server as well. This, when I started with SignalR, was the only thing I forgot every single time. I always want to call it out because I literally forgot it every single time. I would hit F5, fire an event, curse a lot, stop it, do it again, and then go, oh, I forgot to wire up my endpoint. So if you find that situation happening where you're like, Brady said it would work, it was easy, he made it look so easy, you've probably forgotten this line of code.
So that sounds basically how I wind up doing my development as well. Is I'll forget something really silly, I'll go ahead and start it, it doesn't work, I'll curse, then I'll assume, oh, it must have built wrong, it must have been the compiler that went wrong. Let me just try it again without changing any code, it'll work this time.
I call that insanity, I think.
Yeah, exactly.